Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to discuss another problem. Problem is merge sorted array. Very easy problem. So in this problem we are given two integer arrays, nums1 and nums2. They are sorted in non-decreasing order, meaning they are sorted in ascending order, and two integers m and n representing the number of elements in nums1 and nums2. So m has the size of nums1 and n has the size of nums2. Merge nums1 and nums2 into a single array in sorted in non-descending order. So we have to merge nums1 and nums2 into a single array, and it should be in sorted order, that is, it should be in ascending order. The final sorted array should not be returned by the function, but instead be stored inside the array nums1 only. So we have to not use any extra space for creating the final single array, the single array, right? We will not take any extra space for that. We will use nums1 only for that. To accommodate this, nums1 has length of m plus n. Okay, so total elements when we will merge nums1 and nums2, right? When we say merge, right? Merge, what does that mean? Merge means that we have these two arrays, right? We will make a single array in which all the elements of this array and this array will be there. Okay, but the thing is, here we should not use any extra space because they are saying that we have to do in nums1 only. So this single array, right, which the single array, we have to use nums1 only. So for that, nums1 has some extra space. See, here this is nums1, okay, and this is nums2. So nums1 has only 3 elements, size is 3, and these rest of the elements are for the second array. Okay, so total size of this nums1 is what, m plus n, because when we will merge the elements of nums1 and nums2, total number of elements will be m plus n. M is the size of this, n is the size of this. So nums1 has the length m plus n. All right, so this is what we need to do. We need to merge these together. Okay, now let's see how we can approach this. See guys, here we should not use any extra space, right? We should not use any extra space because we have to do it in this only. So first of all, we will discuss like if we use any extra space, so how we can do it. Okay, so if you already know that if how to do it, if you have extra space, then you can move forward to the optimized solution. So first, let's see if we take extra space, how we can do it. So if I have to merge, right, this has m size, the size of this array is m and size of this array is this. So if I have to merge them, I will take another array of size m plus n. All right, so this has 3 elements, this has 3 elements, so total will be 6. So I have taken an array of size 6. Now how I will merge these together, because see guys, these are itself sorted. This is sorted and this is sorted. So these are sorted, if you see, they are sorted in non-decreasing order. Okay, so what I will do, I will take two variables, I here and j here. Okay, and k will be for this, our single array, right? This is merged array. You can name it as merged array. So what we will do, see, we will check. We have to sort elements in ascending order, right? So if we have choice between choosing 1 and 2, 1 or 2, so which one we should choose? Obviously the smaller one, right? So I will choose 1 and I will put 1 here. That is if nums1, okay, this is nums1, this is nums1. If nums of 1 of I is less than nums 2, this is nums2's j, right? If this is the case, then what we will do in this num, let's say this is merged array ma, so in a merged array's k position, we will place the smaller element, right? Nums of 1 i. okay, so here I have placed 1. So this is the logic. Now see guys, since I have used this element, I have considered it, so I will move I forward because I have already taken this element, so I will obviously not consider it again. And k also will move further because now the next element will come to this index. Okay, So what we will do, I plus plus we will do, and we will do k plus plus. Okay, now again see, this is nums of I 2 and nums of j is 2 again. So now they are both equal. So what either thing you can do when they are both equal, right? Either you can move I or you can move j. So I will move j. So when they are equal, right, in else. So in else we will go when nums of j is less than nums of I or they are equal. So in else, right, what we will do, in MA of k we will place nums to j. Okay, so here we will place 2, and since we have considered this 2, j will go forward. So j plus plus, and k will move forward. So k plus plus. So anyway k will always increment, right? Now again let's see, here 2 is there, here 5 is there, which one is smaller? Smaller, 2 is smaller. So 2 will come here, I will move forward, and this will move forward. Again, 3 is smaller than 5. Nums 1 of I is less than nums 2 of j. So 3 will come here, I will go forward, and j will go forward. Okay. Now guys see. Oh sorry, j will not go forward, my bad. Okay, here j will remain here only. Okay. Now see guys, our nums1 array is still this only, right? These are the extra extra elements, right? Here, these we should not use because only these elements are there in nums1. So nums1 is completed, right? So once one array is completed, we will stop. And whatever elements are left of the second array, right? Those will directly come here. Okay. Because obviously they will be greater than only. And they are in sorted order. They are sorted order, so we can just directly keep them here. Okay. So this was the way, right? This was the way, this simple logic. This is the way for when we can use extra space, right? Here we have used extra space. But this is not the case here. Here we have to make changes in this nums1 only. We have to make the merged array in this nums1 only. So now let's see how we can do that. I hope you have understood this approach. It's this you need to know to think of that one. So just dry run once if you are having any issue understanding this. So we have 1, 2, 3, 0, 0, and 0. So don't get confused, right? This is sorted order up to this. Your nums1 is still this only. These are not included. These are just extra empty spaces. So this is your nums1. And your nums2 is 2, 5, and 6. Alright. Now guys see. From if you have noticed in the earlier approach, I we have taken here, j we have taken here, and we have taken an extra space, right? And k at the starting index of that. But here we have already these elements present at the first at the starting, right? And we have to replace also here only. We have no extra space now. We have no extra space now. So, for example, let's say we have 7 here. Right? I'm just giving an example. Obviously, it will be sorted. So, 7, 8, 9, something like this will be there. But just for assumption purpose, let's say 7 is here and here it's 2. Alright. So, what we have to do ideally? We have to bring the smaller element first, right? So we will swap 2 with 7 like this we'll do. But guys see, now this is not sorted. This is not sorted, right? But this should be sorted. So the earlier approach which we have used, we have to change something in that, right? We have to change it somewhat. What we will change, let's understand that. So what we have concluded that we cannot change these values, right? We cannot change these values, but we can add new values here. New values can be added here, right? Why new values can be added here? Because these are empty right now. We can add new values here. And since nums1 should be in sorted order, right? It should be sorted. So at the end will be the larger values. Larger values will be there, right? सो नाउ आई होप यू आर गेटिंग सम वॉट दैट वॉट वी विल डू फर्स्ट. अर्लियर वी आर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग राइट इन द फर्स्ट अप्रोच. नाउ हियर सिंस दीज एम्प्टी वैल्यूज आर द बैक एट द एंड राइट सो वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द एंड. ओके सो वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम एंड. दिस इज वन पॉइंट एंड सिंस वी आर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द एंड द bigger values we will put first. The bigger values we will put first, right? So this is basically the approach. Let's dry run once. It will be more clear. So let me write the this again 100 and this is 256. Okay. So see what we will do. Now we have to start from the end, right? So K I will take here. At the last position where the first larger element will go. J will be at the last here. And I will be where? Just think. I will be here. Because this is the end of the nums 1. This is end of the nums 2. And this is the end of the merged array. The merged array end element will be this one. Okay. So now let's see how we will proceed about it. First of all, here we have to place the larger element. So we will compare nums of I with nums 1 of I with nums 2 of j, and we will check which one is greater. If nums of 1 this is greater, then we will, because we have to place the larger element first, right? So this will be a sorted array and here the larger element will come. So if nums 1 of I is greater in the nums 1, see it will be nums 1 of k, we will place the larger element, nums 1 of I. And what we will do, we will do k minus minus because k will now come here, and we will do I minus minus because this nums of 1 of I we have taken, so I will go to the next element, I minus minus. Alright, if this is the case, else it will go in as if nums j is greater, right? Nums 2j is greater, then in the nums 1 of k, we will place nums 2 of j, right? And we will do k minus minus, j minus minus. So let's see this. Let's see that this in action. So here, k will be there. We will compare 6 is nums 2 of j and 3 is nums 1 of I. So which is greater? 6 is greater. So 6 we will place here. So here 6 will come. K will decrement. It will come here and j will decrement because this we have already taken. So j will come here. Again, 3 is less than 5. So it will again go in else. And here 5 will be placed. And what we will do? 5 will place here. We will decrement j because we have taken 5 and k will also decrement. Now again, 3 is greater than 2. So now this it will go in if, and in the nums of 1 of k here we will place nums 1 of I, that is 3. So 3 will come here and we will decrement k and I also will decrement because we have taken this 3. Okay, now again nums 1 of I is 2 and this is also 2, so they are equal, so it will go in else. It'll go in else and here at the place of k we will place nums 2 of j, so 2 will come here, 2 will come here and j will go out of the bound. Now j is out of the bound, so we will stop our loop. When any of the array is out of bounds, we will stop. And the rest of the C, this is rest of the is already sorted. This is already sorted. Okay. So, this is what we have to, this is what the logic is. At the end, suppose like, let's say suppose I was finished first. So, for the J elements which are left, we'll have to move them to these positions, right? So, that for that you have to use extra loop. So, I hope you understood the approach and the dry run. Let's see the code once. So see, we have taken three variables, I at the last end of the nums 1, j at the end of nums 2 and k at the end of the this whole nums only. So while I is greater than 0 and j is greater than 0, this means that once any of the it has gone out of bound, we will come out of the loop. So this is first condition, else condition. At the end, this while loop, why we are using these while loop? This while loop means, for example, see, here j was finished, right? Here j was finished first, so j was equal to minus 1, right? Here it was 0, then it became minus 1. So it became minus 1, and it minus 1 is not greater than 0, so this condition will become false, and it will come out of the while loop, and it will go in this, if I is greater than 0. I was here, right, at 0, 1 index. So I was greater, 1 is greater than 0, I is greater than 0. So we will place the elements which are left at this k position. So k will go here, we'll place it here, k will go here, we'll place 1 at the position of k. Although they are here only, but yeah, that's the logic. So, and while, if I was finished first and j is left, so we will put the j elements at the remaining positions. So, I hope you understood this. Time complexity is O of m plus n, and space is constant, because we have using this only. Why time is m plus n? Because see, here we are, just see this only. How many times the maximum iteration can go? M plus n times, the total number of elements. That many times we will compare. M plus n times. So I hope you understood the problem and the approach. Let me know in the comments if you have any doubt. If you found the video helpful, please like it. Subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.